What is ROS? ROS stands for Robot Operating System, and it's not a real operating system. It's more like an environment. The big strength of ROS is this ability of connecting nodes together. Nodes are pieces of software that can be written in C++, Python, that is my favorite, and we're going to develop in Python actually. They can take care of a small subset of tasks, for example, reading a sensor or controlling a servo. Those nodes connect together thanks to a publish-subscribe protocol. What does it mean? It means that if a node has an information to share, it will share this information using a topic. And if another node is interested in that information, it subscribes to that topic and reads the information. Now, there are multiple versions of ROS, that is ROS and ROS2, but I won't be covering ROS2 in these tutorials. And there are a lot of distribution of ROS. I'll be using Kinetic. How can I make a video series about ROS? I mean, ROS is so huge. How can I make it interesting for you guys? Because a step-by-step guide could be too boring to follow, and if I make it too quick, then you can't follow it along because it's too fast. So how can I make it interesting and fun for you, but also something that you can apply in your robotic project? So here it is what I'm gonna do. In my next series, I'm gonna be using this setup over here. Just an RC car, a Raspberry Pi 3, and a camera, and a servo control board. Probably gonna be using also a peak sock and something else. So we're gonna be seeing in the next future, in the next videos, some add-ons, but this is the very basic core. This is a donkey car. You can find the instruction for building one in the description below. It's pretty easy, just a cheap RC model, Raspberry Pi 3 model B or B plus, a servo control board from Adafruit, and a Raspberry Pi camera. Cheap, easy, and it's gonna be pretty fun to do. In the next video, we're gonna set up the environment and we're gonna create one simple node so that we can remotely control the car using the keyboard on our computer. It'll be fun, it'll be easy to follow, and you can apply the same principle for developing your project. Okay, guys? So this video is just for giving you a heads up. Follow the instruction in the link that I put in the description below, and I'll see you guys next time with the first video. Can't wait. Bye.